Root canals aren't fun. A dentist drills off the top of an infected tooth to access the soft tissue inside. Then the infected dental pulp is removed and replaced with tiny rubber rods called gutta percha, and the repaired tooth is capped with a crown. What's left behind in the mouth is basically a dead tooth with an enamel tombstone. Now, scientists say they have found a way to use peptide hydrogels to stimulate growth of new blood vessels and dental pulp. They say the new process could help save infected teeth. They presented this work at the recent American Chemical Society National Meeting in Boston. Vivek, Kumar, and Peter Nguyen from the New Jersey Institute of Technology sought to develop a material that could be injected in place of the gutta percha. Their quest began with peptides that self-assemble into a gel when injected under the skin of rats and mice. The self-assembling peptides contain protein snippets that mimic human growth factors. Kumar wondered if the hydrogel, which has been shown to stimulate blood vessels, could be tweaked to enhance regeneration of dental soft tissue. So he and Nguyen added a piece of protein that makes dental pulp stem cells grow toward the self-assembling peptide. When the team added the peptide to the cultured dental pulp stem cells, they found that it not only caused the cells to multiply, but also activated them to deposit calcium phosphate, the mineral that makes up tooth enamel. Now, the team is injecting the peptide hydrogel into the teeth of dogs that have undergone root canals to see if it can stimulate dental pulp regeneration in a living animal. If these studies go well, the researchers plan to move the hydrogel into human clinical studies and have filed a patent for the redesigned peptide. Although in its current form, the hydrogel probably won't reduce root canal pain, Kumar and Nguyen say future versions of the peptide will likely contain analgesics and antimicrobial domains to potentially reduce the likelihood of reinfection and hopefully make root canals a little less unpleasant.